The International Women's Day is one of the days that celebrates women's achievements, raises awareness about discrimination, and takes action to drive gender parity. This year's national celebrations will take place at the Boma Grounds in Katakwi District under the theme Accelerating Gender Equality Through Women Economic Empowerment, which is derived from the global theme Counter In Accelerating Gender Equality Through Economic Empowerment. Despite the female population growth over the last 50 years, the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development has underscored significant loopholes that still need major redress amongst the women folk.
When we talk of access to services which requires money, women are still not accessing because of lack of economic empowerment. That's why you still find 189 women still die giving birth out of 100,000 live births, because most women do not have enough money to go to hospital. When you look at dropout of girls after all level, because universal secondary education stops at a certain level, you find most of them dropping out than boys. Why? Because of lack of economic empowerment.
The 2020 MasterCard Global Index of Women Entrepreneurs indicated that Ugandan women are very enterprising and estimated that women own nearly 40% of all businesses. However, with these statistics still relevant, women still face the negative repercussions of gender gaps in the labor force and businesses.
The low-paying jobs are where women are dominating. The high jobs that people sit to make decisions in the boardroom, women are very few.
Nevertheless, the government has undertaken a number of initiatives to counteract such grievances, of which interventions have greatly benefited the economy, doubling from 64 trillion shillings in financial year 2010-2011 to 162.12 trillion shillings in financial year 2022-2023.
Women with their husband, when you're married, your matrimonial property cannot be mortgaged without your consent. Two, we put the provision of certificate of equity. So any government budget, before it is approved in parliament, any government ministry or department that gets money from parliament is supposed to be assessed whether your budget meets gender equality.
Other steps taken by the government include the amendment of the PPDA Act 2003 to incorporate women among special interest groups to benefit from the 30% provision on local content. Also, the ministry is implementing the GROW project supported by the World Bank with $217 million, including $40 million for refugees and refugee host districts, which targets 60,000 women-owned enterprises, including 3,000 refugee-owned businesses, among others. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.